Candidates, good evening to you all. Hope you had done well in this prelims exam. See, at the outset, the questions are, I agree, not that easy, deceptive, and beyond the comprehension. Let's admit it. But for those candidates with little bit of understanding about the subject, okay, they may stand a chance of faring better. Okay. It is not, as I have been telling you people, factual anymore. It is conceptual. For history, it is conceptual entirely. Okay. Of course, one and two questions in culture, the temples given, they are factual, right? More than conceptual. Unless you have an overall view, it is difficult to answer this paper. I do agree. Okay. As usual, you see 2-3 questions from ancient, 4 from medieval, and the rest modern. Modern continued to play a very important role. Okay. 20 questions altogether we got. Right. Now we are making an attempt here to analyze the paper and to give you a formal key. Right. Okay, what stands valid as per the, you know, alternatives given. This what that I am telling you may not be absolute. UPSC may have its own key. Okay. But, you know, we had come very close to the, you know, most probable answers for every question. To begin with, okay, this is the analysis I am giving for test series A. A, to begin with, modern India. In modern India, you see question number 3. The first quarter of the 17th century, in which of the following were the factory or factories of English East India Company located? 17th century, first quarter. That means, years wise what? 1615, right? 1615 means 17th century. First quarter means 1625. See the alternatives given. Broch, Chicacol, Trichy, Trichinopoly. My dear, Chicacol, this word, Srikakulam in coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh. That word Chicacol is not the same. It is the word of the French. Right? English got Northern Sarkars, including Chicago, from Nawab of Hyderabad, 1766. Nawab of Hyderabad, Nawab Nizam Ali granted them in 1766. That means, that is in the second half of the 18th century. Similarly, third one, Trichy, Tiruchirappalli, that comes under Carnatic Wars, you remember? English, you know, getting Carnatic under their control in the second Carnatic War. So, alternatives, Chicacol and Trichy, they don't come under the first quarter of 17th century. Then, Broch, yes. English tried first to get into Surat, but it was not materialized due to opposition of the Portuguese. Right? They succeeded. When Thomas Rowe visited the court of Jahangir, they got permission to settle in Broch. So the right alternative, Broch. Only Broch. No Chicacol, no Trichy. That's why answer A. For the question, it is A. Next you see, with reference to Madanapalli of Andhra Pradesh, which one of the following statements is correct? I can tell you with all my certainty, I am the only faculty, I think, I have discussed this. Okay. When Home Rule Movement was going on, Theosophical Society President Annie Besant founded National Schools and Colleges. National College was founded at Madanapalli. H.G. Cousins was the principal. Principal's wife, Mrs. Cousins, she set the tune for National Anthem, composed by Rabindranath Tagore. This happened in Madanapalli during Home Rule Movement.
So answer given here, Rabindranath Tagore translated the national anthem from Bengali to English. That's absolutely right. Okay. You can also add, principal's wife, Mrs. Cousins, she had set the tune for our national anthem. Okay. Pingali Venkaya, first one you see, designed the tricolor Indian national flag. Pingali Venkaya presented to Gandhi in 1921 October Vijayawada session. Right. Pattabhi Sitaramaya led the Quit India movement of Andhra region. Pattabhi, he comes from the coastal belt of Andhra Pradesh, Godavari districts. Right. Madam Blavatsky and Colonel Olcott set up headquarters at Theosophical Society first here. You know, Theosophical Society was founded first in New York, then it shifted to Adyar, Chennai. Got the point? So alternative here, C is the alternative. Right. Next, 39. Consider the following statement. Saint Francis Xavier was one of the founding members of the Jesuit order. You know, my dear, Jesuits means Catholic priests. Portuguese Catholic priests, you call them Jesuits. Saint Xavier visited India when Alfonso de Souza was the Portuguese governor, Alfonso de Souza. Xavier died in Goa, buried in Goa. If you go to Goa, you can see Xavier's dead body preserved. Saint Xavier's church is there. Okay. Here Saint Xavier died in Goa and church is dedicated. Absolutely right. The feast of Saint Francis Xavier is celebrated in Goa every year. Absolutely right. All the three statements are right. So answer B, 1, 2, 3. Right. Next, consider the following. Montagu Chelmsford Reforms 1919 recommended granting voting rights to all the women above the age of 21. That is a wrong statement. Okay. There is no voting right. Voting right was by literacy and property criterion. Okay. Franchise for women, England of course the first country to give after World War I, but not in India. Okay. Second one is what? Government of India Act 1935 gave women reserved seats in legislature. That's a right statement. Okay. So answer is what? Okay. Answer here. Okay. Which of the statement given above is or are correct? Only two is correct. Answer must be B. B is the answer for that. Right. Next question. With reference to 8th August 1942 in Indian history, which one of the following statements is correct? The Quit India Resolution was adopted by AICC. Yes, my dear. Gavalikar tank burned. Maidan in Bombay, AICC ratified the decision for Quit India Movement. Decision for Quit India Movement already taken in the Wardha session of CWC. AICC ratified. Absolutely right. Viceroy's Executive Council was expanded to include more Indians. This happened much before. Right. Congress ministries resigned. You know, my dear, Congress elected governments resigned during 1937 elections. They resigned in 39 when World War II started. All these things happened before ratification of AICC decision. Cripps proposal, you know, 1942 March Cripps came to India. Right? So Congress ministries resigning, Viceroy's Executive Council expansion and Cripps proposals all happened much before AICC decision, right? So with that means they all happened before 8th August. So the answer is, okay, Quit India Resolution was adopted by AICC. That's the right answer. A is the answer. Right. Next, who among the following is associated with the songs from prison? A translation of ancient Indian religious lyrics in English. Generally, this is a very clever way of framing the answer by UPSC. See the alternatives. First one, Balagangadhar Tilak. You know, Tilak wrote Gita Rahasya. when he was in jail, right? Mandalay jail. Similarly, Jawaharlal Nehru also, they enclosed the time in jails. Okay. No one would expect Gandhi writing this. Answer is Gandhi, not Sarojini Naidu. Okay. Sarojini Naidu, Nightingale of India. Okay. But it was Gandhi who translated. Okay. Translated ancient Indian religious lyrics, right? Songs from prison. That's answer is Gandhi. Right. Next, who among the following was associated as a secretary with the Hindu female school, okay, which later became known as Bethuven female school? Class, you know, boys and girls preparing, you know, for civils, you know, Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar, the greatest reformer, I should say, okay, who dedicated life for woman education and woman well-being, right? Vidyasagar closely connected with Bethuven school, appointed as a secretary. Got the point. So it goes without saying, Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. Any recent was not connected with that. Alternatives, Devendranath Tagore, the, you know, Tattva Bodhini Sabha, Brahmo Samaj, Devendranath Tagore connected. Sarojini had nothing to do with that. Right. Answer is Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. Right. Next one. In the context of colonial India, Shahnawaz Khan, Prem Sehgal, Gurbaksh Singh Dhillon are remembered as, it goes, you know, without a second thought in your mind, all these great commanders, Shahnawaz Khan, Prem Sehgal, Captain Dhillon and Lakshmi, very closely connected with INA, right? When INA armed forces were defeated, they were all trialed, they were kept in Red Fort, Delhi. Trial of INA officers started. Got the point. Alternatives given or what? Leaders of Swadeshi and boycott movement, they never participated. Members of the interim government, 1946, not at all, they were in the jail. Members of the drafting committee, they are in the jail. So you can't expect that all happen. Officers of the Indian National Army, that's absolute right. So D is the answer for that. Okay. Then with reference to Indian history, which of the following statements is or correct? The Nizamat of Arcot. Nizamat of Arcot means the state of Arcot. Arcot emerged out of Hyderabad state. That is absolutely right. Nawab of Hyderabad, you know, the richest, I told you, the biggest state also, Hyderabad. Out of the state Hyderabad, Arcot was formed. Right. Then Mysore kingdom emerged out of Vijayanagara Empire. Yes, absolutely right. Wadiyars, the landlords of Mandya and Mysore. Okay. The kingdom of Mysore rose to prominence on the ruins of Vijayanagara Empire. Then Rohilkhand kingdom was formed out of the territories occupied by Ahmad Shah Durrani. Ahmad Shah Durrani means Ahmad Shah Abdali. Ahmad Shah Abdali's attacks started from 1748-49 onwards. Already by that time Rohilkhand was formed. Ali Muhammad Khan founded Rohilkhand, close friend of Nadir Shah. So this third statement, my dear, that is totally wrong. Answer is A. What do you mean by A? 1 and 2. First and the second statements are right. Next, you see questions in medieval. Okay. Women in Vijayanagara Empire were expert in which of the following areas? Okay. Wrestling, astrology, accounting, and soothsaying. My dear, okay, in Vijayanagara Empire society means you have newness comes first. Fernão Nunes, the great Portuguese chronicler. He gives us a graphic account about position of woman, evils, everything. For Nunes, women were employed in different fields, right? There were women wrestlers, women bodyguards, right? Soothsaying, that means counseling you and comforting you, understand? Nunes also talks about prostitution, gambling, right?
Everywhere you see, for Nunes, women's participation recorded. So women were into wrestling, astrology, accounting, soothsaying. I should say answer D, 1, 2, 3, 4, all correct. Next question, consider the following statement. It was during the reign of Iltutmish that Genghis Khan reached the Indus in pursuit of fugitive Khorasan prince, Khwarizm prince, or it is Khwarizm prince. Okay. That's absolutely right. Genghis Khan, Timurchin, the first Mongol to attack India. It all happened during the times of Iltutmish. Chasing Khwarizm prince, okay, he threatened to attack Delhi. Okay. But he had not attacked. Partly it's because of his respect for Buddhism, the land, you know, India, the land where Buddhism was born. He had not attacked. The statement is valid. Second one is what? It was during the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq that Timur occupied Multan. That is wrong statement, you know. Timur entered India 1398. By the time Muhammad bin Tughlaq already died, 1351. So this statement is wrong. Next, it was during the reign of Devaraya II of Vijayanagara Empire that Vasco da Gama reached the coast of Kerala. This is equally wrong. Devaraya II died by 1462. Vasco da Gama entered India 1498. Okay. Right. 1498, you know, Jamarin of Calicut receiving May 17th. By that time, already, you know, Devaraya II died. Okay. Salwa dynasty were the rulers. Right. Then, which of these statements given above is or are correct? Answer is A. That means only one is correct. A is answer. First one is correct. Right. Next. With reference to medieval India, which of the following is the correct sequence in ascending order in terms of size? Wonderful way of asking question. Little bit of understanding, you can solve this. If you know little bit understanding about administrative systems of medieval India, you can do it. Okay. What are the alternatives? Paragana. What is Paragana, my dear? Paragana means group of villages. Second one, Sarkar. Sarkar means group of Paraganas, group of mandals or taluks, otherwise Paraganas. Next, Subha. Subha means province. A three-tier system. Three-tier system, just as you have a block, mandal, okay, block or mandal, district and state. That's absolutely right. So the right answer here, A. Okay, Paragana, Sarkar, Subha. Right. Next question. Which one of the following ancient towns is well known for its elaborate system of water harvesting and management by building a series of dams and channelizing water into connected reservoirs? Okay. No better example than Dholvira. Okay. The Dholvira, the city with wonderful system, illustrated system of water distribution, water conservation. Okay. You have rock cut tanks there to preserve water. Okay. Then rain harvesting, you know, plants were also seen. Okay. Rain harvesting methods seen. Okay. In Dholvira. Okay. You dig pits, soaking pit, you understand, for conserving water. So right answer for this is Dholvira, undoubtedly. Okay. Fine. Next one is, from the decline of the Guptas until the rise of Harshavardhana in the early 7th century, which of the following kingdoms were holding power in North India? That means the transition period from Guptas to Pushyabhutis, Harsha, who were the ruling dynasties.
when Gupta Empire collapsed, it does not mean Gupta Empire ended altogether. Madhav Gupta continued to rule in Bihar. Okay. Now you see the answers. Guptas of Magadha, I mentioned Madhav Gupta, he is the ruler of Magadha. Okay. Paramaras of Malwa, Paramaras came much, much later, okay, after Harshavardhan. Pushyabhutis of Staneshwar, Harsha comes under Pushyabhutis, absolutely right. Pushyabhutis were feudatories, Samans, subordinate rulers of the Guptas. So this is right. Okay. Guptas of Magadha, Pushyabhutis of Staneshwar, Maugharis of Kanauj, yes, that's also right. They were there. Yadavas of Devagiri, my dear Yadavas of Devagiri, 12th century, right? Not before that. Then Maitrakas of Vallabhi, that's also right. Okay. So here answer must be B, 1, 3, 4 and 6. These were the dynasties. Okay. Between Guptas and Harshavardhan. With reference to the history of ancient India, which of the following statements is or are correct? Mitakshara. See, this question is the main problem. For me, what the answers they had given, they are not convincing me. I might be wrong, I don't know. Candidates, for me, all the alternatives are correct. Okay. That's why in the key, I have not given, you know, my stand, my key. B is not, I am convinced. For me, all the three are correct. What are the statements? Mitakshara was the civil law for upper caste and Dayabhaga was the civil law for lower caste. Dayabhaga is definitely liberal, very liberal. It is the law for present times we call it as. That way, Dayabhaga liberal in sense what? It accommodates lower caste. Right? Number one. In the Mitakshara system, the sons can claim right to the property during the lifetime of the father. Whereas in the Dayabhaga system, it is only after the death of the father. That's absolutely right. You can claim. By virtue of your birth, you cannot claim. It's only after father's death you can claim. Mitakshara system deals with the matters related to the property held by male members of a family. Whereas Dayabhaga system deals with the matters related to the property held by both male and female members of family. This is also right. Okay. This is also right. Kindly check it. You people kindly check it.
Okay.
For me, all the three statements are right.
Okay.
With reference to the history of ancient India, Bhavabhuti, Hastimalla, and Kshemeshwara were famous. Number one, Jain monks. Bhavabhuti is not a Jain monk. Bhavabhuti wrote Uttar Ramacharitra, great dramatist. Bhavabhuti compared with Kalidas in personal merit. Cut the point. So these were all great playwriters. Bhavabhuti, okay, playwriters. Temple architects, no, they are not connected to temple architecture. They are not philosophers either. So right answer is, okay, B is the right answer. Then with reference to, okay, Chausta Yogini temple situated near Morena, okay, consider the following statement. This I doubt anyone, okay, answering this question with certainty. Okay, nobody expected a question like this. And one specific temple, that too obscure, not so popular. If you are giving a question on, you know, Brihadishwara temple or Konark Sun temple or Lingaraja temple, I can understand. Okay, Kandivaraya temple and other temples, Madhira temple. But you see an obscure temple like this. Okay. Definitely difficult question. Okay. I am sure that, you know, you some may perhaps get it by luck, by fluke, you understand, correct? But definitely not a confident answer one can give. Okay. But we searched out later and we could frame the key for this. Okay. What is the key? C is the answer. Okay. 1 and 4. That means, okay, it is a circular temple built during, okay, Kachapagata dynasty. Such a remote dynasty, Kachapagata dynasty. It is the only circular temple built in India. This is wrong. Cut the point. First statement is right, second statement is wrong. Okay. In Aihole also, we have temples built in circular shape, looking like our parliament foundation. Right? It was meant to promote Vaishnava cult. That is wrong. In the temple, this temple you see Shivalingas. It is not Vaishnavism. Its design has given rise to a popular belief that it was the inspiration behind Indian parliament building. Absolutely right. It's all circular. Circular structure means parliament looks like that, you know. So the answer is C. 1 and 4 are right statements. Agreed. Okay. Next, consider the following pairs. Historical places well known for. First one, Burzum. You know Burzum, my dear, in Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir. Burzum, a Neolithic site. Burzum, known for what? Double burial system, okay, pit dwelling, right? It has nothing to do with, okay, rock cut shrines, right? That's not correct matching. Then Chandraketu Ghar, this comes close to Kolkata, Chandraketu Ghar. Terracotta art, yes, it is very famous for terracotta art. Ganeshwar in Rajasthan. Copper artifacts, yes, definitely. Ganeshwar comes under Chalcolithic age, known for copper processing. Okay, so second and third, okay, they are right choices here. Answer is D. Next, which one of the following statements is correct? Ajanta caves lie in the gorge of Ogara River. Again, this is a very difficult question. Generally, in art and architecture, we expect questions on the themes of paintings, themes of monuments, but they are giving questions on the riverbanks, okay, which is something unexpected. Right? You can't expect candidates also to go by the topography, geographical location of the site. That too, art and architecture wise, okay, that is adding too much burden. Okay. We are heavily loaded in art and architecture with music, painting, you know, literature, architecture, bhakti, Sufi movements and all that. With great difficulty, we could definitely figure certain important sites, important in terms of culture. If you give a question on location, that too on river basin, it's definitely difficult for anyone. Okay. Ajanta caves in the gorge of Ogara River, that is absolutely right statement. Sanchi Stupa lies in the Chambal River, that is not correct. Okay. Pandulena cave shrines, gorge near Narmada River, okay, this also not correct. Okay. Amaravati Stupa lies in Godavari. Amaravati comes under the banks of Krishna, okay, not Godavari. So B, C, D wrong. Answer is A is right. With reference to India, the terms, okay, Halbi, Ho, Koi, these are all languages, tribal languages. Got the point? There is nothing called Halbi, instrument, Koi, right? Dance forms, there are no dance forms of North India, Halbi, Kui and all that. Okay. Prehistoric cave paintings, you can't name them like that, you see. Okay. Prehistoric cave paintings, you know where it was all. Bimbitka, right? Adhamgar, right? In Madhya Pradesh, right? They are definitely tribal languages. Tribal languages in the Chota Nagpur belt, Chhattisgarh, Odia, Jharkhand belt, you have these languages. Okay, fine. Next, that's all. Okay. This is all part of history, culture, and modern India part of gender studies question paper you got. Candidates, don't get disappointed. My sincere, you know, suggestion to you people, if it is tough, tough for all, not only for you. Okay. Are you in a position to correct the, you know, answer the questions, attempt the questions which others could do easily? Okay. There you shall not be, you know, lost out. Got the point? Okay. If it is tough, it's tough for all, not only for you. Okay. So don't get disheartened on that account, thinking others must have done well. Now I am telling you with all my experience, the paper is not that easy. Okay. Best of luck to you all. Okay. Do well. Start your preparation today itself for your mains. God bless you all. Thank you.